Hello, class of 2020. This is Assistant Principal Boyce. The faculty, staff, and administration at Jordan High School empathize with the feelings of lost and missed opportunities that our seniors are experiencing. From not completing courses on campus face-to-face with your teachers, to losing the spring sports season, senior nights, concerts, and banquets, missing your friends and seeing them in the hallways and during lunch, to now, losing the opportunity to walk across the stage and receive your diploma the way that seniors who came before you were able to do. With all of this in mind, I'm still very excited to finally be able to share the specific plans and instructions for your 2020 graduation celebration. We are calling the June 11th graduation a celebration rather than a ceremony on purpose. Teachers, administrators, parents, and community members have been hard at work for the past month planning and preparing for what we hope will be a truly unique and special day that you will remember for years to come. From amplifying your music, preparing gift bags, decorating, and more, we are working to ensure that you are celebrated the way you deserve. Before I get into the specifics of the day, let's hear from Ms. Maychette, Dean of Student Services, with some important reminders for seniors.
Hey, Jordan Falcons, it's Ms. Maychette, school counselor, with some student services updates. We want all of you to graduate with options. Whether your plan is to enroll in a college or university, be employed, or enlist in the armed services, we want to make sure that you have somewhere to go next year where you can thrive and use all the skills you've learned the last 12 years of school. If you have yet to decide on a plan for after high school and you would like some support from your school counselor, please reach out. Our contact information is on the Jordan website. The next thing is regarding surveys. There are two surveys that we need all seniors to fill out. These senior surveys help counselors know where students are going next year. The post-graduation survey is linked on this slide and on the graduation tab. We need everyone to fill it out. The scholarship award survey lets us know what scholarships students have received. These scholarships don't have to be scholarships you're using. Maybe it's from a school that you aren't actually going to attend, but still let us know because that's still a scholarship and an award that you earn because of your hard work. Please fill out these two surveys by June 3rd. It is important to us that all students are eligible to graduate. Letters were sent home specifying any remaining graduation requirements for each student. If you did not receive your letter or you have questions regarding your letter, please contact your school counselor. The deadline for any remaining assignments is June 5th for graduation participation. If you have questions, we are here to help. We want to make sure that you finish high school strong and that you graduate with great places to go. You've worked so hard and we are so proud of you.
An overview of our graduation includes three main components: the drive-through celebration, which will take place on June 11th, beginning at 9 a.m., a live stream of that graduation, and a virtual ceremony that will be compiled and completed and accessible online prior to graduation starting. The drive-through celebration will include music, students' names will be announced, diplomas handed out, photos taken that will be provided to you for free, and gift bags handed out. The live stream, of course, can be watched while students are in line on mobile devices or by family members and friends who are not on campus who want to participate as events are taking place. The virtual ceremony will include students' pictures along with their name being announced, as well as speeches by students and administrators. In order to help families avoid sitting in line for a long period of time, students with last names A through F are asked to arrive between 9 and 10 a.m., last names G through N between 10 and 11 a.m., and last names O through Z between 11 a.m. and noon. Students will be verified when they arrive on campus. When families arrive on June 11th, you will need to enter through the carpool drive, also known as the student drive, at the far end of the soccer field. You will follow that drive around to the traffic circle and continue up back towards Garrett Road on the other side of the soccer field. Officers will be available to assist with turning right back onto Garrett Road and then right again into the front drive of the school. You will then proceed through four stations at the very front of the school, stopping at each station, and then exit through the bus parking lot back out onto Garrett Road, which will be a right-hand turn only. While families are in line waiting to receive their diploma, they can enjoy several of the items that our team has put together for you to enjoy, including positive message signs along the route, Jordan teachers and staff cheering on students, decorations at the front of the school. Of course, you can watch the virtual ceremony, including the student speeches, on your mobile device, or you can stream the senior slideshow from our YouTube channel. You can also watch the graduation live stream and see your peers ahead of you in line receiving their diplomas from Ms. Taylor.
Hello, Jordan High School class of 2020. We are less than 2 weeks away from celebrating another milestone in your lives, your high school graduation. We realize that this year has been a bit challenging, but we are ready and excited to celebrate this major accomplishment in your life. One of the important events that will happen on this day is the calling of your name. So we're asking you to help us to make this a memorable event. We're asking you to complete the Google form that will be submitted via CE Jordan's Falcon Instagram page, Twitter, our parent PTSA site, and through your English teachers. On this form, you will be allowed to upload a file that will either have a picture of the phonetic spelling of your name, or you can actually write it out on the form. Please help us to help you make this day a memorable occasion with the correct pronunciation of your name. Soar high, Falcons. Looking forward to celebrating you.
Seniors must be in their caps and gowns upon arriving to campus. This will be a part of the admissions process. Only one vehicle will be allowed per family. Each vehicle must have an eligible graduate inside. Vehicles without a graduate will not be allowed through the procession. Also remember that no party buses, limousines, etc. are allowed. The graduate should be on the passenger side of the vehicle so that they can readily receive their diploma, get their picture taken, and receive their other items. Drivers are asked to be sure they refrain from using their phone while driving on campus, and always remain aware of your surroundings as there will be other vehicles, people, and decorations throughout. Families are reminded that everyone must remain in the vehicle at all times throughout the graduation, even when students arrive at the four stations at the front of the school. Once your vehicle arrives at the front of campus, you will proceed towards station one, where you will stop for a picture frame photo. You will then proceed to station two and stop to receive your diploma cover and have a photo taken with Principal Taylor. This will be done without shaking hands. Also remember that your tassel remains on the right side of your cap until you receive your diploma. After having your picture taken with Principal Taylor, you will proceed to station three and stop to receive your diploma. Then you will proceed to station four and stop to receive your gift bag. After receiving your gift bag, you will continue along the designated path to exit the bus parking lot back onto Garrett Road. Again, this will be a right-hand turn only.
Hello, everyone. Congratulations to the class of 2020. Since graduation is going to look very different this year, we would like to invite you to be a part of decorating our campus and preparing it to receive our seniors. If you are able, please prepare signs of encouragement and acknowledgement for the class of 2020. Signs can be made of poster board, mat board, fabric, or vinyl banner. We will display these signs on the fences lining the student drive and through the circle as it winds back to the front of the school for the awarding of diplomas. Most signs will be displayed on fencing, so plan accordingly when preparing your signs. We will also be able to display a limited number of yard signs in addition to the signs on fencing. If you're planning to have a sign made, consider supporting a local business and get faster delivery. We are going to collect all signs prior to graduation so that they're ready to go on the day of. So please drop off all signs at the JHS parking lot on Monday, June 8th between 2 and 5 p.m. There will be a small number of staff prepared to collect and organize the signs during this time. You will be able to come back and get your sign after 3 p.m. on Thursday, June 11th, the day of graduation.
but any signs remaining on Friday, June 12th will have to be discarded. If you would like to coordinate with an athletic team, a club, or a special interest group, we're happy to hang those signs and banners and posters together. We encourage you, if you're going to do that, to designate a couple of drop-off spots to collect your materials prior to coming to campus, and then have one or two vehicles bring the group of signs to Jordan in batches. This will reduce the number of cars through the front lot and ensure that your posters are grouped together. We encourage you all to use this as an opportunity to show your school spirit and your graduates how much you appreciate them.
In addition to providing positive messaging signs to post on campus, we encourage families to decorate the vehicle that you will arrive at graduation in. This is an opportunity for you to celebrate and be proud of the accomplishments you've achieved over the last several years. Finally, encourage family and friends that aren't riding along to watch the live stream, virtual ceremony, and senior slideshow wherever they are, and celebrate with you even though they can't be here in person. In conclusion, I want to thank Principal Taylor for her support of the many ideas and efforts that have gone into preparing for your celebration. I also want to thank our teachers, community members, and parents for stepping up to help us make the 2020 graduation celebration meaningful and special. Finally, I want to thank you, the senior families, for pushing through. This is undoubtedly a tough time to graduate from high school. However, you have risen to the challenge. We look forward to celebrating each and every one of you on June 11th. Thank you, and take care. Our eyes unafraid.